programming from elsewhere in the world can be really excellent and, you know, very imaginative and great in storytelling terms. There's one thing it doesn't have, is it doesn't reflect our children's lives.
Faced with an onslaught of hit American imports, British producers needed bankable ideas. Many believed the TV of the future could be found in the past. Old favourites, including the Wombles and Rupert the Bear, were remade for a new generation of kids.
Hello.
We were presented with ideas. So, for example, the estate who owned Bill and Ben came to the BBC and said, would you like to make a new series of it? And I guess we recognised the good storytelling, the personality-driven stories that existed within those programmes, and thought that it would be great to bring those to life in a modern context. So we did remake Bill and Ben and Andy Pandy and Dennis and Asher and a number of other shows, but really it was to bring back the stories for a modern world.
That's right.
The thing is, Dennis, we have decided that it is time you had a haircut.
And if parents had right recollections of the terrestrial era, where there was 1, 2, 3, 4 channels, but we live in a multi-channel society now. I think in a certain sense, when they see remade programmes like Andy Pandy and Bill and Ben, I think they feel reassured. I think there's a strong sense in which they see their own childhoods, and they feel very comfortable with the idea that their own children are watching these kinds of stories.
Andy was missing. In his special cupboard, he'd found an old box. It was full of treasures. There was a great big key, a broken green crayon, and a broken purple crayon. Then a huge lump of fluff.
I think the whole nostalgia thing is quite clever.